has started overreacting. Don't worry, comrades. There are many things happen in the struggle. Struggle is not a bed of roses. When you put a bed of roses, there are thorns underneath it. So when you walk on the roses to get something tangible, the thorns that there will prick you and make blood come out of you. So we have to bear the pains. Pain will be there in any part of struggle. Struggle cannot be conducted without sacrifice and pain. And the MRI workers, the MRI members are ready to give this sacrifice, and that is why our leaders have sacrificed over the days the organization and built the organization which could achieve the cherished vision of all that membership. No words can actually give our gratitude to them. So many unnamed faces, so many sacrifices of our leaders have made us what we are today. So what I was telling in Glenmark also there will be. They have got, first they were told that we'll approve your leave. They threatened all the workers. Now they have all been given a warning letter. Okay? Warning I have got, but I have my democratic right to carry on my trade union movement. As a supportive measure we have given. December they went on Moscow's leave. In the month of focus, January you have seen. We know that there will be threatening from the American. If you all remember in the month of January, the focus is one day demonstrative program by all the council, all the state units and the council subcommittee in front of Glenmark. But the Glenmark field workers have gone on strike on our call. To save their colleagues, they have gone on strike at the call of FMRI. What is FMRI strike? The state units? The subunits, if you don't respond to the call, it feels that only such magnificent mass casual leave program was not backed up by a strong demonstration program across the country. Why don't you do it, comrade? We must understand. We must review. If the demonstration program in the month of January would have been successful across the country with hundreds of workers of the subunit assembling in front of Glenmark offices, the management would have been satisfied. So we will repeat the program in February in an effort that they do the demonstration program in the right earnest to protect the Glenmark people. Let us make it a point and agenda of this General Council meeting that we go back and organize a strong demonstration program in front of the CNFs or offices of Glenmark. So, successes I have said, Sun Pharma. Our struggle in Glenmark continues. But the most important factor in this, any struggle, I talked about Wallace also. All in the months of in the year 2018 against the companies will continue. But where we have to see? We have to see only one thing, that when a worker is on the path of struggle, in this socio-economic situation, there are various methods how he is distracted. So our basic idea of contacting, keeping our council subcommittee and the subunits is meant for this action only. That those who are in the struggle, you should have live contact with them so that they get the confidence of continuously participating in the struggle. Many of our leaders are self-motivated because of their continuous participation in various trade union programs throughout the country. That is an ideal situation, but we have not been able to percolate it down as per our desire. The workers' vacillation starts coming from that point because they don't regularly participate, especially the bilateral group of companies and the companies where we are fighting for the rights, these 45 companies. Vacillation starts from the point that the workers do not have live contact in their subunits. But we cannot leave it like that. The workers have gone, what can I do? Can I leave it like that because this is my organization? If a worker goes from my organization to the part of the management, I become weak and then they become stronger. So can I leave it? So we have to act. And one of the most important action programs is maintaining life contact with the workers, especially in those cases where there is struggle. Policy. What is the fight for? Two victimization issues across the country. There are so many victimization taking place in companies where there is no recognition. Coming and going, we don't have any information. But in a company where we have bilateral relations, the management gives in writing that I will not discuss any disciplinary measures, I will only discuss charter of demand. Can we accept that position? I know you will say we cannot accept. And rightly, FMRI has not accepted that position. We have rejected that position and we have said that in spite of the charter of demands pending for more than 4 years, our Wallace field workers are on the path of struggle to have their right of trade union and to protest against the one of the five cardinal points, that victimization cannot be done by the management arbitrarily.